I'm standing just outside of a temporary home for almost 2,000 people who fled New Orleans to come here seeking shelter. And we have some video from inside. This is the old Lucent Technologies plant. They have cots set up for people so they can sleep there. And you can see some people standing around a computer and also TVs for them as well, so they can get updates on the news and find out what's going on back home. They have free meals. We have several agencies working together to make sure that these people have the basic needs during their time here in Oklahoma City. And Eyewitness News 5's Amanda Guerra joins me now live. And Amanda, there were some problems, though, as soon as the buses pulled up.
Yeah, Jessica, workers here at the shelter say originally they only expected a few hundred evacuees, but as the buses arrived this morning here at the shelter, they quickly found out they were getting a lot more than that. Just before sunrise, buses full of evacuees started to arrive. Shelter workers say they were anticipating just 8 buses and about 400 evacuees, but before they knew it, 34 buses had pulled in, bringing nearly 2,000 people.
Really, it's you know, with 1,800 people, it's like a small town.
The surge of evacuees caused some problems for the shelter. For instance, not enough food.
There is food available in there, but to get there, you have to survive a line that's, you know, that's been pretty long.
Another problem, a lack of cots.
You know, I thought they may have some cots ready or something like that, but apparently that's not the case either.
Workers say they've solved that problem by ordering an additional 2,000 cots from Tulsa, but for these evacuees, the cots weren't the biggest problem.
They don't have no place for no one to take a shower or nothing, you know, clean themselves up.
Workers say the portable showers are on their way, but until the showers do arrive, evacuees say they're using their own toiletries and cleaning up in nearby restaurant bathrooms.
Coming to the subway and using their bathrooms, yeah. You know, for the time being, until, you know, they get their stuff together in there.
And I was told those showers did arrive just a little while ago. Now you can see a lot of people walking around here. Police say they are trying to keep everyone safe. They did run everyone through a criminal background check. So far, they've arrested 6 people. 3 of them had warrants, another 3 for disorderly conduct while they've been here. Reporting live, Amanda Guerra, Eyewitness News 5.
Amanda, thank you.